Jermell's number three in my Papa Pomus. This reporter is asking the coaches, where would they rank Jermell if he wins? I'm saying he's already there. He's undisputed at 54.
But, you know, how big could the win be for Jermell when it comes to pound for pound?
It's a big win regardless.
Who's that question for, Alan?
All of the coaches, but maybe Robert to start with, because he started the conversation earlier.
Okay, I'll start. You know what? I think the win would be so big that I'll put him right behind Dennis Crawford. I still think Dennis Crawford will be number one, but I'll put him right behind him, number two.
Yeah, good call. I'm second that. Reason why, and this is the thing that get me with the rankings. If somebody do something that somebody ain't done, and it's a significant win, and the public going forward, and it's pushing boxing forward, he should be there. I mean, you look at the win that Spencer what's his name had. Hey, that was something great that he done. You know, so what Robbins just said, I agree with him 100%. It puts him right up there with.
Thanks, Kevin. Roddy, would you have him number one?
Yes, sir. I don't know if I would put him number one. I thought I'd be like these guys, and I would say number two. Because, you know, you got to give Crawford his props right now.
Yeah.
You know, such a big fight. But for guys in their prime, you know, so I would have to say number two behind
Crawford. Is it a clean sweep, Bob? Do you think number two as well?
No, I put Charlo, if he wins this, I put him number one to be undisputed, going across, like I said, from 54 to 68. I understand, you know, everybody considers Spence maybe a little bit more in his prime than Canelo, but Spence he hasn't accomplished what Canelo did at that level. So for me, if he goes out there and he beats Canelo with everything that Canelo's accomplished, And in the magnitude of the event, I don't think there's any bigger fish in the sport right now than Canelo. I think he's the king. He's the mantle. He's carrying everything right now. You know, he's the bus driver driving the bus. And so if he goes out there and he wins that fight, definitely to me, Charlo becomes pound for pound number one. And I have obviously Crawford just a hair underneath.
I agree with Bob Sanchez on that.
Just a hair.
And just so you know, Kelvin, I got Gervonta way high on my pound for pound list too.
I appreciate that. Some people don't have that,
but for me, I have him there right now, right there too, in that top two or three.
I appreciate that, but like I said again, when you look at Crawford, he did some. You got a good point about Canelo with his accolades that he had. You understand? But Charlo ain't on the pound for pound. Crawford was already mentioned in that pound for pound. That's why I kept him at number one, because he did something great, you know.
We're going to have to debate that pound for pound list, because I don't know what's going on here. Gervonta be way higher for me than all these other guys, because I've seen him twice.
And
how Charlo's not on that pound for pound list, I'll be fucked.
He is. He's number three or number two.
You're not a top three. I don't know. We got some guys on pound for pound list. They don't fight but once every 4 years. But I got
Yeah.